guys, so today we're gonna do another deco mesh wreath, and it's gonna be a blue and silver one today. So I'm gonna show you how I do it, and you can just follow along if you're interested. And yeah, so let's get started. Okay, so I'm gonna use this wreath wire thing, and I have my pipe cleaners and my deco mesh. And for starters, we're gonna take our pipe cleaners and wire cutters, because you will ruin the crap out of your scissors, and just cut them right down the middle. So I cut up one package, and then if we need the other package, then we'll just cut those up as well. But for right now, I'm doing one package at a time. So I take my deco mesh and I will just fold it like so, and then take my pipe cleaner . Do one round and then stick it here. And then get like a good bunch. And then you want to do the last row and the top row. So that's what you want to alternate it every time. So I'm gonna bunch it, take my twist tie or my pipe cleaner, and you can go as big or as small of like a section that you want. I like mine a little fluffier, so I'm gonna do it fluffy. I'm gonna do about like this size. Take my pipe cleaner and then twist it around back, and then go to this side. Get it as tight as possible. The twisty part, or like these parts behind it, so you want to try and keep them in the back so that it looks like this. And then you're just going to keep going all the way through. And that's what the first section looks like. And then just to do, to get over this, you just do the same thing. So you don't need to worry about these little sections. You just go about them as if they're not there.
Thank you.
make sure you take the tape off when you're done at the end. Okay, and that completes the wreath, or well, all the deco mesh portion of it, and then we're just gonna fluff it out. And you just pull it and move everything to your liking and make it as fluffy or as tight or however you want it to be. And make sure that all the ends of the pipe cleaners are in the back, like so. I mean, you'll need them later, but that's fine. And that is that for the deco mesh part. And then we're gonna move on to ribbon. Okay, so we're moving on to ribbon. So we're gonna go, I have these three things of ribbon. I'm gonna use these two to wrap around, and then I'm gonna use this one for the bow. Since this was extra from a different wreath, I'm just gonna use up the rest of this for my bow and use these two. So I'll show you how to do that, and then we can determine which part of the wreath you wanna put your bow on. And then set up for decorations. Okay. So this is where the pipe cleaners come in handy. Because then you put it in between like that, and then can wrap it. So every time you do one, you wrap it with the pipe cleaner. that is the first ribbon on here. La, 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 la. And time for the second one. And then I like to go over it. So it'll like crisscross on it. For this one, we're not gonna twist tie it. We're just gonna go over under. Sometimes it just doesn't work out how you want it. Like, I wanted it to crisscross over the blue. It's not happening, so we will just work with it this way, which is fine. No big deal, because it still looks pretty good. I'll just twist tie that off. Okay, that is done. Time to make the bow. Okay, so we're gonna make a bow, and I'm gonna incorporate both of these ribbons because I don't think I'm gonna have enough of this ribbon. So just to make it look fuller, I'm gonna use both. So I'm gonna take both my pieces, and they're both the shiny side up, as you can see, and then I'm going to twist. And then fold. And then twist. So that the non-shiny parts are not facing us. And then fold. And then twist. Fold, or twist, I guess. And then, come on, cooperate. And then twist. Fold. take these ones and go around so that it looks like this. And then gotta cut this. I'm using wire cutters because these have wires in them and it just makes things so much easier to do that because I've ruined my scissors. And then we will take this piece right here, and you gotta figure out where you want your bow. And then we'll fluff it out after. I'll show you how to fluff it out, but figure out where you want your bow because it will get bigger once it's fluffed. So figure out where you want that and get your pipe cleaner from behind. Actually, we're gonna just get a new one. Okay, put it around the whole thing. So your pipe cleaner's holding it, but this will cover it. And then put, because I'm gonna put the bow right here, and you wanna attach it to the middle, or the metal. So just attach your pipe cleaner anywhere on the metal wreath. Okay, so to fluff it out, you just want to go like this. And just take them apart like so, and just fluff it out. And then you fluff it to however you like it. I'm gonna do it the way I like it, but everyone's taste is different, so you can just fluff out your bow to your liking. And you definitely don't have to do the two colors like I did. You could do it simply with just one ribbon. But I did two just because I wasn't gonna have enough of the one and I wanted it to be big and fluffy like so. So that is my bow, and I will cut these shorter. Voila. So that is that part, and we're done with the ribbon. Okay, so now that the wreath is done, I'm gonna add lights. So I got these branch-like lights, and let's see. So they light up, and I'm gonna wrap them around the wreath. So I will show you how to do that. Do that. that. Okay. Now I'm gonna start off with the end with the battery pack because that is going to need to be hidden back here. And then we're gonna just take our pipe cleaners and wrap the lights around it. Just gonna shove that there for the moment. And then I'm just gonna spiral it around like I did with the ribbon. Just tie it off with the pipe cleaner again in the back. When you're satisfied with the placement of your lights, and since this part is just flopping in the wind, we'll hot glue it so that it will be hot glued to the top right here. So, and you could do that with like the rest of these pieces as well. You can piece it about and, oh man, I flattened this. We could fix that. But I'm gonna go grab some batteries real quick so we can see how pretty it looks. Ooh. So this is what it looks like, all lit up. Very pretty. I like it. And like I said, we'll hide this better at the end when we're all done. So for now, I'm going to... Ooh, it light. Look at that. You can have, there's different settings on it. This is fading. Ooh. This is flashing. This is steady, and then there's off. So cool. Okay, time for decorations. So have your hot glue gun plugged in and ready to go, and we will start decorating is put my decorations on first before I hot glue anything. So I will like just start placing things everywhere and see where I like them, and then I will start hot gluing everything and doing all that. So I think I'll start off before I put any decorations on is start hot gluing the branches so that they are more spaced out and look really pretty. Okay, so I've hot glued everything that I want hot glued for the moment. Now time to play with decorations. So you don't want to do anything, like hot glue, anything, until you are satisfied with the placement of all of your decorations, because it would suck to put everything on and hot glue it and then be like, ugh, I don't like the placement of this, and then want to change it. So you definitely want to play around with it until you like it and then hot glue it at the end, because no one wants to sit there and have that headache of having to take it off and potentially ruin it. So that's what I like to do. So far, I got where I want everything, so I'm gonna start hot gluing the stuff that I want hot glued.
for good or you have to leave? Lights are so cool. They have like three different like settings.
And that is the completed wreath. Let's see where, whoops. Can see that cute little star hanging down in the middle. But, all right, so for this, we just take, we should probably keep it. Just gonna wrap the cord up like that. And then just kinda shove it in there like so. That way it's shoved, it's lodged in between the two wires. That way it doesn't go anywhere. And then when you want to turn it on, I don't know if you can see it with the lights on, but look at how pretty that is. Ooh, sparkly. And then just fluff, you're just gonna wanna, oh man, that fell off. And then you're just gonna wanna fluff up this. That but fell off. Okay, so that is the completed wreath, and I really hope that you enjoyed the video and that it helped you out in making yours. And if you enjoyed the video, give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you can see all future videos from me. And if you want to request anything or want to see me make a different wreath of whatever toys, just let me know in the comments below, and I will do my best to do that for you. All right, have a good day, guys.